You're watching Game Show Network. Ladies and gentlemen, from New York City, Bill Collins.
Say, that is a good line, Bill. Thank you. That's okay. Thank you kindly. Yeah. Thank you kindly. You're all right. You're welcome at my house anytime. Thank you. It's me again. Gary Moore's away, so this is old Bill Cullen welcoming you to another edition of To Tell the Truth. Hey, first up today, we have a mayor, a guy who dances up a storm, and some soul food. Now, before we get to all of that, why don't we meet some of our truly hotshot members here on our panel. Panel, where are you? Nipsey Russell. Kitty Carlisle. And Peggy Cass. Oh, are they not nice? Hello, panel, and welcome to the place. We are.
Yes.
Sensei. Look at this.
Oh.
Yeah, Peggy has a pom pom and a pom pom.
What's this?
Yeah. So that is something for you. We want you to dig in there. Your chore, panel, you see, is to separate the people from real people, and you're going to do some eating. These are chitlins.
Chitlins!
I'm going to do something eating. I'm
now before,
not eating that.
Now you, huh?
No.
It's part of the contract. You must eat what we have here.
Right.
Yes, you made your bed, so
I'm
eat
not
it.
Eating
yeah. Now, before you taste them, don't rush into it. Before
don't
you taste
worry
them,
about rushing into
I
it.
Want you to know that our first guest, a little trouble, a little resistance, has really put the lowly chitlin on the map.
I love it.
Now,
it's nice.
You do?
Love it. You
know,
right.
Jimmy Carter's president, they have chitlins on the glass in the White House.
Oh, they do?
With peanut butter salad.
All right, while they're talking about the chitlins, let us meet our first guest right now. May we please, sir?
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Jack Abel.
Number two.
My name is Jack Abel.
Number three.
My name is Jack Abel.
Okay, now you go ahead and eat, panel. Don't let me disturb you. You just eat to your heart's content. Your choice is to separate the real Jack Abel from his two imposters. And here's his story about the celebration of the chitlin. I, Jack Abel, am the mayor of Sally, South Carolina. When I took office, Sally was in a sorry state. Then I got a crazy idea. I'd make Sally the chitlin capital of the world. Well, it worked. Recently, the Chitlin Festival attracted 22,000 visitors from all over the country. It even started a new dance craze, the Chitlin Strut, which has been described as the shimmying of a 54 Ford with a bad front end. With the proceeds from the festivals, we've bought a new garbage truck, a new fire truck, new street signs, and we've remodeled the jail. Signed, Jack Abel. Go ahead, dig in. There's more in the kitchen.
Yes.
We'll be back here in two flicks of a lamb's tail, but first, lay your ears back, if you would, and listen to this.
Now, for your home and shop, one amazing blade that cuts through practically anything. This is new Multi-Disc. It's safe, it won't break or shatter. It's amazingly flexible. It will never bind or kick back your work. Multi-Disc cuts through this rock-hard ash baseball bat. It cuts through copper and iron pipes. Plastic pipes are cut off clean. There's no melting. Multi-Disc is diamond and carbide throughout. It's one of the best grinding wheels on the market. It shapes tile, grinds away paint, rust, and debris in seconds. Call toll-free or send for Multi-Disc now and start saving hundreds of dollars on single-purpose blades and wheels. Best of all, Multi-Disc will work on any rotary tool in your home or shop. Put it on your household drill, and it cuts like magic. Multi-Disc cuts like a blade and grinds like a wheel, and you can use it on any rotary tool you own. Multi-Disc sands for mica, while it cuts so there's no chipped edges. Call or send now. Cut perfect angles and grind curves in ceramic tile. Cuts picture frame perfect moldings and trim. Hobbyists love it for detailing plastics, metal, and wood. Now, in this limited time offer, you get two multi-discs, a universal arbor to assure they'll fit all your rotary tools, and our unconditional money-back guarantee, all for only $12.98. Order now.
These days, fund managers seem to come and go. Some take unexpected hits from the market. Others disappear because of poor performance. Larger companies often transfer managers, and then transfer them again. And then there's always someone who falls victim to shareholder discontent. Through it all, Ken Huebner has managed CGM Mutual Fund. Over 15 years, the fund has achieved a total return of 870%. A little continuity goes a long way. For a prospectus, call toll-free 1-800-CGM-INFO.
If you need a Visa credit card, we have a special offer just for you. We guarantee to give you a credit card with no security deposit required, regardless of your past credit history. Almost everyone will be approved for a Visa card, even if you've been turned down before. If you meet our minimum requirements, your approval is guaranteed. Our offer is for an unsecured credit card. This means that you're not required to send in a security deposit. Don't miss this limited offer to obtain a Visa card with no security deposit. Call our number now. An application will be sent to you immediately.
Prime Games is getting ready to entertain you on Game Show Network.
Hey, on Thursday, we got great game show hosts on Family Feud.
We are talking Bill, Colin, Bob, Eubanks, Jim Perry, Jim Lang, Betty White.
And what about me?
That's a great game show host.
Oh, good point. How about Password with Rosemary Clooney?
That's good. And we've also got a guy who can whistle like a bird with 10 cigars in his mouth. Can you do that?
I don't think so.
You can do an awful lot with a foot in your mouth.
Well, I am talented. But what's that got to do with it?
Where's your show?
Check out the action on Prime Games this Thursday only on Game Show Network.
I guess with chitlins, you just have to get used to the idea that they are chitlins. But how are they, Peggy?
Delicious. Good. Delicious.
Okay, good.
I'm not
going
to be a liar.
Okay, yeah.
These kinds that are kind of rough, these are
they're
not
boiled.
Good.
They're
but
not good.
The boiled, well, anyway, the fried ones are good. They're kind of good.
You better get this thing Lance.
I just want to mention that they were warmed up for us by Terry McMillan of South Carolina.
Well, she can warm up a few of these fried ones.
You like the crisp ones. Okay, keep that in.
Yeah.
Panel, remember all these three men all claim to be Jack Sable, Mayor Jack Able, mayor of Sally, South Carolina, and originator of the Chitlin Festival. We begin the questioning with that Chitlin lover from way back, and a lot up front, too, Peggy Capp.
Number two looks so mad at me, I'm going to start with him. Number two, what is a Chitlin?
The intestines of a hog, the same guts of one.
Yeah. Either way.
If the intestines are the guts, is that the same thing?
Right.
Wonderful. How do you fix them? Number three, how do you clean them? Oh, my God.
Well, you scrape them, then you turn them inside out and scrape them again.
Right.
Yeah, good. And then, number one, do you rinse them before you fry them?
Well, you boil them for about 6 hours, and then you fry them in peanut oil.
What else? Number one, you seem so friendly. How much are they a pound?
44 cents.
Can you buy them frozen?
Yes, you can.
I have a feeling you set the chitlin market back seven years.
No, I don't mean to do that.
You like the crisp ones.
Those boiled ones that are...
Okay. Nipsey?
Yes, love all southern food. You don't see me hiding my watermelon in a bowling bag. Number two, what is crackling bread?
Cracklings is the fried skins.
Yes, all right. Number three, chitlin strut was once applied to an affair where chitlins were sold and dance music was played. Are you familiar with chitlin struts in that connection?
The only chitlin strut I'm familiar with is the one Jack West started 4 years ago.
Yeah, all right. Number one, what is a hog moth?
A hog moth is one of the...
Oh, too bad. I guess you don't have to answer. Once that buzzer, how about you, Kitty?
I want to know, number three, what's the difference between chitlins and... Which I like, come from the South, too. I like it. What's the difference between chitlins and tripe?
Tripe is from a beef. Chitlin is from a hog.
I see. And what was that thing you asked about?
A hog moth.
What's a hog maw, number one?
Hog maw is one of the termites that attacks the hog.
Oh, I'm so sorry I asked that.
Yeah.
Oh. How many attacks?
Oh, please. Yeah. Number three, what is the pop? Let's get off this. What is the population of Sally?
570, not counting the hogs.
And number two, how many hogs do you have?
100.
Oh, you know, really like that. That's wonderful.
That was 100 before he prepared this meal for you right here.
99. No.
Yeah. Soupy, you're going to wrap it up.
I like to wrap them up and throw them away. It says here that the chitlin strut, which has been described as the shimmying of a 54 foot with a bad front end. I had a date the other night with a chick. Number one, chitlins, you can go outside of most grocery stores in the South, and they're out there. It's like grab as grab can. They've really become very big, haven't they?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Number two, what are scuppernongs?
Scuppernongs, they grow on a vine similar to grapes.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. We should have brought some of them. Because I was born in the Carolina. I knew you'd be thrilled about that.
I don't know. None of you have helped our chitlin cause for what it's worth. Okay, well, I'm glad. Time's up anyway, and it's time to do your voting panel. So kindly select over there. Vote for either number one, number two, or number three. Reminder, we pay $50 for each right vote, and if our panel is fooled completely, the challengers split $500 up amongst themselves. Allmark, Balasar, okay, Peggy, your vote, please.
I know a scuppernong you make wine out of, but I don't know what it grows on. Number two, a hog maw. A maw must be his mouth, like oxen maw, I think. So I voted for three.
Okay, that's one vote for number three. Nipsey, you seem so confident through all this.
Well, I know I've eaten these foods for years. Hog maw is the stomach part of the hog. His maw, the part of it, the end part of his intestine. Uh-huh. Scuppernongs and muscadines are types of grapes from which wines are made, and I know number two knew that. A chitlin strut is like a fish fry. It's an affair at which chitlins are served.
I see.
Number two has got to be the right one.
Okay, now how about you, Kitty?
Well, I voted for number three. Uh-huh. I thought I voted for number three because he looked like a politician.
And here's a fellow also from down south, Soupy.
That's right. I was born in North Carolina, and nobody ever knows what a scuppernong is. And number two knows what a scuppernong is, and I voted for him.
Okay. The votes are all in. Let's see who did well and who didn't. Will the real Jack Abel please stand up? Yeah. Boy, I'll tell you, confidence over there. Real. I never saw two panelists as confident as Nipsey and Soupy were there. They seemed to have the idea, and they were the imposters did a pretty good job. Number one, would you tell us your name, sir, and what you do?
My name is Sam Girard. I'm from New York City. I'm a fine artist, and I've never been near a chitlin.
Any plans on getting near chitlins in the...
No, I smelled them backstage.
I'm sorry about this, sir. With this thing about Gerard, that's a familiar name. Are you any relation to the member on our staff
yes,
here?
Yes, I am.
Andrea...
Andy's my daughter.
And she's our talent coordinator. And I'm going to say the talent is right in the family there. Number three, tell us about yourself and what you do, please.
My name is Oscar Carr, and I'm development officer for the Episcopal Church of the United States of America.
Okay, now, we told you all about the chitlin strut and stuff like that. Panel, I just want you to know that you are in luck, because we're going to, in just a minute, direct from Sally, South Carolina, you're going to meet the king of the chitlin strut. Its originator, the inimitable Jack West. But let's get a bit more background on this successor to the black bottom and the bunny hug and the turkey trot. Jack Abel, could you fill us in on just what this is?
You know, since the trend is on diets and everybody's wanting to exercise, Jack West started a new one, and so you want to see something, every part of him moves. And
every
so now that's a good exercise for anybody who wants to go on a diet and I want to exercise to reduce. Now, sure. You watch it.
I haven't had any exercise like that for 20 years, I don't think. So hang on there, hang on to your chairs or whatever you want to. Direct from Sally, South Carolina, the one and only Jack West dancing the chitlin strut.
Thank you.
West. We thank you, Jack West, for your dancing demonstration, and Jack Abel and Imposters for being with us play Tell the Truth. Thank you, Patty. My golly, that's class and culture is all I have to say. And speaking of class and culture, we are such stuff as dreams are made on. Shakespeare said that, you know, not of, but on. That's the way he said it. Our next guest agrees. She knows all the whys and wherefores of dreams, and we'll meet her and some of her friends right, well, give us a chance to interrupt any reveries you might be having. Here comes that guy again.
What can make your tomorrow better than today? A promotion? A great-paying job? A new career? At ICF, more than 10 million men and women have prepared for new careers without setting foot inside a classroom. And now at home, in your spare time, you can get your diploma or degree. Choose from any one of these courses. Then call toll-free for free information about training with ICF.
Call 1-800-351-1500 right now for free information. There's no obligation, so call 1-800-351-1500.
I need you now.
Hopeless romantic like me, you'll love this new collection from Westwood. It's called All for Love. Check it out.
When can I see you again?
You get loving favorites from Richard Marx, Babyface, John Cicada, Paula Abdul, and many more. These songs, or just love great music, then All for Love is for you. Get it on two cassettes for $21.99 or two CDs for $26.99.
To order All for Love, call the number on your screen or send check or money order for $26.99 for two CDs or $21.99 for two cassettes, plus shipping and handling to the address above.
The greatest stars in television history appear on Game Show Network.
Will you enter Mystery Challenger and sign in, please? Mr. Hackett.
Are you a singer?
Professionally.
Yeah, professionally.
No.
Have you been in New York in a nightclub or in a hotel room this season?
Professionally.
Professionally, yeah.
See your favorite stars on Game Show Network.
And now, as promised, let us meet an authority on dreams.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Rosalind Cartwright.
Number two.
My name is Rosalind Cartwright.
Number three.
My name is Rosalind Cartwright.
Okay, panel, if you're ready, here is Rosalind's story. Listen carefully. I, Rosalind Cartwright, am a dream researcher. Everyone dreams. In fact, the average person averages one dream in every 90 minutes during a normal night's sleep. Dreams are a form of primitive picture language, an attempt by the brain to deal with the day's problems. If we learn to read this picture language, we might solve some of these very problems. Research shows that we can monitor our dreams and even control nightmares until the terror is gone. Even more interestingly, we've found that some people's dreams pick up information from others. This adds to the theory of thought transference. Dream research is still in its infancy. We've just begun to unlock the treasures of the mind. Signed, Rosalind Cartwright. Okay, we're going to unlock the deep recesses of the mind. Nipsey, why don't we begin with you? Unlock the mind there.
All right, Rosalind, number three, I've been told that man usually dreams of only two things, what he fears most and what he hopes for most. Is that true?
No, that is not true.
I see. Number two... Are dreams ever a carryover of your waking thoughts?
Definitely.
Number two, still, is it possible to discontinue a dream by waking up, go back to sleep, and resume that dream?
It is if there's a very short period in between the time the sleep is interrupted and resumed, but it has to be less than 2 minutes.
I see. Number one, do people have a recurring dream essentially the same thing, the same experience over and over?
Yes, many people do.
I see. Are those usually pleasant experiences?
No, often they're very fearful experiences.
Okay, back to number three. What's the...
Oh, time is up there. Kitty, what do you want to know about dreams?
Oh, thank you. Number one, does this have anything to do with Freudian and analysis and dreams?
Does the present work
have
anything to do with it? Well, he certainly legitimated the field of dream research.
But it has nothing to do with psychoanalysis.
No, it's a separate study.
Number two, I dream mostly what happened during the day with very little variations. What can I make of that?
Most people do dream of what happened during the day, but I'm surprised that you have no variations. Perhaps you do and you don't remember them.
That's possible. Number three, how do you take the terror out of nightmares?
Mainly by waking up.
Is that the only way?
I'm afraid so.
Oh, number two, you don't have any other way of taking the terror out?
Well, I think if you have a recurrent nightmare, it probably is a sign that you have some sort of disturbance and perhaps some psychotherapy would be indicated.
You're telling Kitty that she's nuts?
Yeah. Kitty, you don't look to me like a person without variations.
No.
I'm sure you have some sensational variations. And now, from the sublime to soupy.
Number three. When I was a kid, they said if you tell anybody your dreams before you eat breakfast, they won't come true. Right. Is that... You ever heard that?
No, I haven't.
Well, you're much younger. number two, can you dream? Anybody ever dream in color?
Most people do dream in color. You dream exactly the way you see things in your waking life.
Really? Is that... Well, number one, is it because the mind is never at rest and that's why you dream?
That's right. We're turned on mentally 24 hours a day.
Well, do you think, number three, could it possibly not be Freudian or any psychological, just be that your mind is doing a...
Rerun, a reprise
of what you have done during the day?
Quite often our dreams are exactly that, a reprise of what we have done during the day. Not in all cases, but quite often. It does not have to have psychological...
Clock goes off and hands you a residual. Peggy,
Number one... Suppose you have a cheese sandwich and a kosher pickle and a glass of milk before you go to sleep, and then you start dreaming like, Billy be damned. May I ask you, is there any significance to that? I mean, anybody can dream up a storm if they eat something terrible.
No, what you eat does not affect how much you dream. It may control the content of the dream if it gives you a tummy ache.
Well, the quality
of
the dream.
You may have a particular kind of dream.
But number three, I was interested, you said that... dreams are not significant, but psychoanalysts really feel that all dreams are significant. Even if you dream a reprise, as you said, it's still significant.
Oh, I didn't say they were not significant, but I said they did not all have the psychological implications that many people believe that they do. They can just be very mundane recurrences.
But the thing is, although they might seem mundane to you, maybe a trained analyst would think they were far from mundane. Isn't that so? I mean...
In many cases, yes, but not in all cases.
Thank you. Number two, when did dream interpretation...
Oh, well, that's interesting. I have questions of my own. Time for you to vote, panel. Get ready to mark your ballots, please. Mark them for either number one or number two or number three. $50 for each wrong answer. You know that. $500 is a whole bunch of stuff. Nipsey, you have your ballot mark yet, please, sir? Got to step right along here, so if you'll vote for us.
It was only a nightmare. It was only a dream, but it tortured me all through the night. Six women were fighting to make love to me, and the ugly broad was winning the fight.
I know the feeling. I know it well.
Kitty, number three.
Kitty, how about you?
I'm concerned about that male chauvinist dream. Really. I voted for number one. I think that she knows. Number two said that most people dream in color. I don't think that's true. I think most people dream in black and white. Quite unusual to dream in technicolor.
I dream in color.
Well, you're unusual,
so
darling.
I asked that question, but I'm colorblind, so I don't know what I did. But they're all were just great. But I think number one is the one.
Okay, final vote is yours, Peggy.
Well, you won't believe it. I voted for number one, too.
Look at that.
The rest of them talked a lot more.
I know. You have great confidence. Okay, let's put your minds at ease so you won't dream. Will the real Rosalind Cartwright please stand up?
Howdy,
thank you, Rosalind. The Foster's did well. Didn't get many votes, but did well. Number two, would you tell us who you are, please, and what you do?
My name is Alice Fleming. I'm a freelance writer here in New York.
Okay. And number three, how about you, please, ma'am?
My name is Felice Itzkoff. I'm an administrative assistant with SGI International, a consumer marketing company in New York City.
And thanks to you, Rosalind. Rosalind Cartwright and Imposters for being with us on To Tell the Truth. Thank you, ladies all.
Brittle nails that break and won't grow? Get Nutri-Nail. Short, brittle nails grow in just 5 to 7 days. Nutri-Nail. Short, brittle nails grow. Guaranteed.
Gorgeous spiral curls are easy to perm at home with the Pro-Perm Spiral Curl Kit. It has it all, even spiral rods. Pro-Perm, beautiful spiral curls at home, guaranteed.
Now do away with razors, cuts, and stubble. The Hair Off Mitten with its special silk coat surface that massages away hair fast and easy. The Hair Off Mitten, amazing.
Victims of drought and famine.
Lack the power to stir our hearts. The simplest thing in the world is to just turn all this off. Turn off babies who are near death simply because they have no food or water. I can't. I've seen too much. But I've seen something else, too. I've seen babies come alive with new health because people have called and become Save the Children sponsors. That's why we urgently need you to call Save the Children. It won't take much, $20 a month. But where children are hurting, that's enough for nutritious food, medical care, whatever a child needs most. In fact, Money Magazine has once again named Save the Children one of America's best charities. So you can continue to turn off the needs. Or you can call this number and say yes to sponsoring one precious girl or boy. I promise, you can help make these haunting pictures go away. Please call.
One loan, one payment each month, and nothing more.
Makes a lot of sense, doesn't it?
If you're like most homeowners, you're paying a mortgage, several credit cards, and an auto loan each month. That's why the Money Store introduced the Combo Loan. With a Combo Loan from the Money Store, you can refinance your mortgage and consolidate your bills. You'll have one loan, one payment, and write just one check each month.
Plus, the interest can be tax deductible.
One loan, one payment with a Combo Loan from the Money Store. Call 1-800-LOAN-YES.
At Game Show Network, there's always something fun happening on Club AM.
Hey, it's Halloween, and we're taking a look at the scariest folks in Hollywood.
No, we're not talking about plastic surgery here. We're revisiting the likes of Alfred Hitchcock and Vincent Price.
And for all you fun-loving trick-or-treaters, we'll be dressing up.
Yippee, and we'll be giving out treats.
As usual.
So tune in and spook out.
Good outfit, huh?
Don't miss Club AM this Thursday at 9 a.m. Eastern on Game Show Network.
Thank you all very much, and join us next time on To Tell the Truth. Goodbye.
In addition to the cash awards, our first team of challengers will receive Sarah Coventry, the exclusive fashion jewelry that you can buy from a friend. Sarah Coventry, the jewelry with know-how. Our second team will receive Pure Wax, the world's largest selling liquid car wax. Cleans, polishes, protects, and one easy operation. Pure Wax with a hard shell finish. This is Bill Wendell speaking for you to tell the truth. Amar Goodson, Bill Totman Production.
It's time to register to play our live interactive game shows. Call 800-537-GAME now. It's fast, it's fun, and it's free. You only need to register once to play forever on Game Show Network.
You're watching Game Show Network.